A public hearing on land was today held at Eldoret Municipal Hall in Uasin Gishu County in a session led by the chairman of the Parliamentary Lands and Natural Resources Committee, Mtava Musemi. In regards to the clause in the constitution that requires an individual to only possess a maximum of 10 acres of idle land, a cross-section of members of the public in attendance at the hearing suggested that anyone exceeding that limit should be taxed heavily. Some people objected to the provision that women be allowed to own land, saying that the clause goes against many of the Kenyan community's customs and traditions. Elsewhere, 19 people arrested in Maralal, Samburu County, after a tip-off by members of the public who were suspicious of the activity, have appeared in court. The suspects told the court that they were on a mission to preach religion through a practice called tablik that requires them to move from one place to another, educating people on Islam. Samburu OCPD Maurice Asila said 7 of the suspects who did not possess proper identification were arraigned in court. Back in Nairobi, the 4th session of the African Ministerial Council on Housing and Urban Development was held at the Kenyatta International Conference Center, officially opened by President Mwai Kibaki. Others in attendance were Vice President Kalonzo Musyoka, Housing Minister Soita Shitanda, and delegates from across the continent. President Kibaki said African countries should strive to provide quality housing facility for the people. From Mombasa, Internal Security Minister George Saitoti says his PNU party will hold its National Executive Council meeting next week. Speaking during the official opening of the PNU Mombasa office, Saitoti said this will precede the submission of the party's application for full registration to the Registrar of Political Parties. And a woman was today arrested at Kiamwangi village in Gatondo South following claims that she severely injured her husband. Jen Jambi is said to have attacked her husband Patrick Kimani with a metal bar, breaking both his arms and ribs. The husband claimed that this was not the first time that his wife had battered him. Area Assistant Chief Salome Wamaitha confiscated the metal bar and a knife that she allegedly found inside Jambi's handbag and took her to Gatondo Police Station. Charity Waweru, Citizen Live at 9.